علماء الآخرة محبتهم لكتب الإمام الغزالي.
The righteous of this ummah, of this nation, used to say that the sign that someone loves the next world is their love for the books of Imam Ghazali.
وعلامة علماء الآخرة الدنيا كراهتهم لكتب الإمام الغزالي.
And the sign of the scholars of this world is their dislike for the books of Imam Ghazali.
وذلك لأنه من علماء الآخرة.
That is because they're from the scholars. He's from the scholars of the next world.
وقال الإمام الحداد بإحياء علوم الدين تحيا قلوبنا.
Imam al-Haddad said in a poem, through the إحياء علوم الدين, the revival of the religious sciences, our hearts come to life.
قال الإمام يحيى النووي كاد الإحياء أن يكون قرآنا.
Imam al-Nawawi said that the إحياء is almost as if it's the Quran.
وقال الإمام السقاف من لم يطالع الإحياء فما فيه حياء.
That Imam al-Saqaf said, whoever doesn't read the Ihya, that he will never attain religious modesty.
وقال كثير من الصالحين لو عاد الأموات إلى الدنيا لما أوصوا الأحياء إلا بما في الإحياء.
Many of the righteous of this ummah, of this nation, take some time.
فدرجات التلقي فيه غير محصورة.
The various ranks of acquiring knowledge are innumerable.
وأقصر رتب فيه رتبة النبي أي جميع الأنبياء صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The greatest of all ranks is the greatest of the prophets, in particular our prophet.
الذي تنكشف له كل الحقائق وأكثرها من غير اكتساب وتكلف بل بكشف إلهي في أسرع وقت.
And that it is for the prophets that all realities that are unveiled to them, or the majority of them without them even trying or seeking to acquire them or any difficulty from their end, rather that it will come through them through a divine unveiling immediately.
وما دام ذكر الاختلاف في شرف المعلومات وخصتها فيذكر الآن أشرف أنواع العلم.
And so because here he mentioned that there's different types of knowledge, some more honorable than others, that he's going to mention now that the most honorable and greatest types of knowledge.
قال وأشرف أنواع العلم هو العلم بالله وصفاته وأفعاله.
And he said the most honorable knowledge is the knowledge that pertains to God, His attributes, and His actions.
فبه كمال الإنسان وفي كمال سعادته وصلاحه لجوار حضرة الجلال والكمال.
And it is the knowledge of this through which the human being attains his perfection, and it is through which he attains felicity and is suits himself to be able to be in the presence of the majesty and perfection of God.
فالبدن مركب للنفس.
And so that the physical body is a mount for the soul.
والنفس محل للعلم.
And the soul is the locus of knowledge.
والعلم هو مقصود الإنسان وخاصيته.
And knowledge is what the human really attends in his distinguishing trait.
التي لأجلها خلق.
That he was created through which he was created for this purpose.
والإنسان على رتبة بين البهائم والملائكة.
And the human being has a degree between animals and angels.
فإنه من حيث يتغذى وينسلو فنبات.
From the standpoint that he seeks provision and gives offspring, that he is a nabat, he is a living thing.
ومن حيث يحس ويتحرك فحيوان.
And from the standpoint that he experiences and feels and moves, that he is an animal.
من حيث صورته وقامته فكالصورة المنقوشة على الحائط.
And as for his form and his physical stature, that he is like a image drawn on a wall.
وإنما خاصيته معرفة حقائق الأشياء.
The distinguishing trait of man is his ability to know the reality of things. Also have a higher degree than the previously mentioned two, but they are also subjugated to the human kingdom.
فإذا صبت خدمات هذه الأجناس الثلاثة عند الإنسان فالإنسان يخدم من؟
In that if these three kingdoms are subjugated to the human being, then the human being, who should he be in service of?
إن قضى حياته في خدمة شيء من الأجناس دونه فقد انحط.
That if the human being spends his life serving one of these three degrees that are beneath him, that he has he fall into a decadent state.
وشرفه أن يأخذ تسخير هذه الأجناس فيخدم الرحمن جل جلاله.
And that his true honor is for him to realize the subjugation of these other three kingdoms and use them for the service of his Lord.
وجعلتك لي.
And it is as if God is saying, I made everything in creation subjugated to you, and I made you subservient to me.
فإذا أبيت أن تكون له كنت لشيء من الكائنات ثم لا يغني عنك شيئا.
And that if you refuse to dedicate yourself to me and partake, he said that he has fallen down to the low level of animals.
قال ويمكن الاستعانة بكل عضو على طريق الوصول إلى الله فقد خسر وخاب.
Whoever uses his limbs for this reason is surely going to be successful, and whoever turns away from this, that they will be in loss.
فيحتاج أن يفقه المؤمن أنه بكل عضو من أعضائه يمكن أن يتقرب إلى الله تبارك وتعالى.
The believer must know that with every limb of theirs, that it is a means for them to draw near to God.
وبكل حركة من حركات الحياة يمكن أن يزداد نور إيمان ومعرفة.
And with every moment of their life and every movement that they make, that they can draw in closeness to God.
وجملة السعادة أن يجعل لقاء الله مقصد أن يجعل لقاء الله مقصده.
And that this comprehensive felicity or the true felicity is for the human being to make his desire the meeting of God, and that his abode the abode of the next world where he truly desires to remain, and to make this world as just his temporary house, his body as his mount. Ahmed Alwan said that he says traveling the path to God is knowledge, and the intellect is the guide.
فالسير علم والعقول أدلة والرب قصد.
And God is the one who sought, and the Prophet is the Imam.
صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. ثبتنا الله على حسن الاهتمام به.
God make us firm.
تمثيل القلوب إن لله تعالى في أرضه آنيا وهو القلوب.
That Sayyidina Ali, may God be pleased with him and ennoble his face, that he drew a parable of the heart, saying that indeed God Most High has in his earth containers, and these are the hearts.
قال فأحبها إليه.
The most brittle, the most pure, and the most firm.
ثم فسره فقال أصلبها في الدين وأصفاها في اليقين وأرقها على الإخوان.
And then he explained what he meant by that saying, the firmest in deen, the purest in certainty, and the most brittle in relation to their brothers.
قال الغزالي وهو إشارة إلى قوله تعالى أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم.
And Imam Ghazali said that this is an indication of the words of God Most High, that they are stern with the disbelievers and merciful among themselves.
ففسر أصلبها في الدين بقول أشداء.
And so this first description of being firmest in deen as is referred to in the words of God, this stern with the disbelievers. That this is the sternness that is praiseworthy.
ليس منها في شيء التعبيس في الوجوه ولا إساءة المعاملة فضلا عن الغش والخيانة.
That being stern with the disbelievers doesn't mean that you frown in their faces, and it doesn't mean that you
adieu Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
and that it is the way of the Prophet in his life, it explains this meaning clearly.
وسيرته أصحابه رضي الله عنهم.
And that the way his companions live, may God be pleased with them.
وإذا جاوروه وجدوه خير مجاور.
And that if they lived close to him, that they found him to be the best of people to live near.
ومن ما جالسه وجده أكرم جليس.
And whoever sat with him realized he was the most trustworthy of people to deal with.
فقبل هجرته من مكة كانت ودائع الكفار عنده وفي أمانته.
That before he made the migration to Medina, that many of the people of Mecca had left deposits and trust with him.
هم يفكرون في قتله وهو يحفظ ودائعهم لا يضيعها.
They're thinking about ways to kill him, and he is taking care of these trusts and things that they deposited with him.
ثم أمر سيدنا علي أن يعقبه ليرد الودائع لأصحابها ثم يلحقه إلى الهجرة إلى المدينة.
And then even as the Prophet was making the migration himself, he ordered Ali bin Abi Talib, Sayyidina Ali, to remain behind in order to return all of these trusts.
ثم حاربوه وقاتلوه ثمانية سنوات.
And then they fought him and battled him for 8 years.
فلما عاد إلى مكة
when he returned to Mecca,
قال من دخل المسجد فهو آمن.
He said that whoever enters into the mosque is that they will be protected.
ومن دخل داره فهو آمن.
And whoever remains in their home that they'll be protected.
ثم قال اذهبوا فأنتم الطلقاء.
He said to them that you are all free, and so go.
بل عند مدخله إلى مكة رأى كلبة عندها أولاد ترضعها والجيش أقبل فوقف وأخذ بعض الصحابة فقال قم في هذا المكان وأهل الجيش يمر هكذا حتى لا يؤذوا هذه الكلبة ترضع أولادها.
To the extent that as he was entering into Mecca صلى الله عليه وسلم with his army, that he saw that there was a pup that was nursing with his mother, with the mother dog, and that the Prophet ordered one of the companions to stand next to this mother dog nursing her pup to make sure that the army, as they passed, that they would not disturb her.
فما عرف الكون أرحم من هذا القلب.
This universe has never known someone more merciful than our Prophet.
قال وقوله تعالى كمشكات فيها مصباح يعني قلب المؤمن فيه النور كمشكات فيها مصباح.
And also the words of God Most High, that it is like a niche that in it is a lamp, meaning that the heart of the believer is like a niche that in it is this lamp.
قال أبي بن كعب رضي الله عنه معناه مثل نور المؤمن وقلبه.
And that Ubay ibn Ka'b, may God be pleased with him, said that this verse means the likeness of the light of the believer in his heart.
وقوله أو كظلمات في بحر لجي مثل قلب المنافق.
And that in the words of God Most High, that or like these successive darknesses that in the depths of the ocean, that this is like the heart of the hypocrite.
وقال زيد بن أسلم في قوله تعالى في لوح محفوظ هو قلب المؤمن.
And Zayd ibn Aslam said that about the words of God Most High, في لوح محفوظ, in a preserved tablet, that this is a reference to the heart of the believer.
إشارة إلى أن حقائق القرآن تحل في القلوب.
This is an indication that the realities of the Quran, that they take root in the heart.
يشهد له قوله تعالى في الآية الأخرى بل هو آيات بينات في صدور الذين أوتوا العلم.
It is indicated in another verse as well that when God says rather that بل هو آيات
بينات,
rather they are clear verses in the hearts or in the chests of those who believe, those who have been given knowledge rather.
ولذا قال زيد بن أسلم بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ قلب.
May God make our hearts a place that the Quran resides.
وقال سهل مثل القلب والصدر مثل العرش والكرسي فهذه أمثلة القلب.
And that سهل التسطري said that the likeness of the heart and the chest is the likeness of the throne and the footstool,
يا أهل حلول أنوار القرآن فيها أن يجعلنا عنده من أهل القرآن وأن يصلح لنا كل شان ويرفعنا إلى أعلى مكان ويبارك في مجالسنا ويبارك في لقاءاتنا ويبارك في أخوتنا فيه ويجعلنا في خواص الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر الذين يحيون على الصدق مع الله ويلقون الله يحبونه ويحب لقاءهم ويلقون في البرزخ حبيبه محمدا ويلقون في القيامة حبيبه محمد ويستظلون بظل لواء الحبيب محمد ويمضون على الصراط في زمرة الحبيب محمد ويلتقون في دار الكرامة بحبيب الله محمد مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. اللهم اجعلنا منهم, اللهم اجعلنا فيهم, اللهم أنلنا هذا الطلب وحقق لنا هذا الرغب وبارك لنا في أحوالنا في الدنيا والمنقلب وادفع عنا جميع الشغب والتعب واجعل أحبابنا هؤلاء مفاتيح للخير مغاليق للشر. سببا لنشر النور والهدى في هذه الديار وجميع الأقطار ظاهرا وباطنا بتوفيق من عندك يا موفق بسر الفاتحة إلى حضرة النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم الفاتحة إلى الدنيا لما أوصوا الأحياء إلا بما في الإحياء.
Many of the righteous of this ummah, of this nation, take some time.
فدرجات التلقي فيه غير محصورة.
The various ranks of acquiring knowledge are innumerable.
وأقصر رتب فيه رتبة النبي جميع الأنبياء صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The greatest of all ranks is the greatest of the prophets, in particular our prophet.
الذي تنكشف له كل الحقائق وأكثرها من غير اكتساب وتكلف بل بقلوبنا.
Imam al-Haddad said in a poem, through the Ihya al-Umiddin, the revival of the religious sciences, our hearts come to life.
قال الإمام يحيى النووي كاد الإحياء أن يكون قرآنا.
Imam al-Nawawi said that the Ihya is almost as if it's the Quran.
وقال الإمام السقاف من لم يطالع الإحياء فما فيه حياء.
That Imam al-Saqaf said, whoever doesn't read the Ihya, that he will never attain religious modesty.
وقال كثير من الصالحين لو عاد الأموات.
Types of knowledge, some more honorable than others. That he's going to mention now that the most honorable and greatest types of knowledge.
قال وأشرف أنواع العلم هو العلم بالله وصفاته وأفعاله.
And he said, the most honorable knowledge is the knowledge that pertains to God, His attributes and His actions.
فبه كمال الإنسان وفي كمال سعادته وصلاحه لجوار حضرة الجلال والكمال.
And it is the knowledge of this through which the human being attains his perfection. And it is
علماء الآخرة محبتهم لكتب الإمام الغزالي.
The righteous of this ummah, of this nation, used to say that the sign that someone loves the next world is their love for the books of Imam Ghazali.
وعلامة علماء الدنيا كراهتهم لكتب الإمام الغزالي.
And the sign of the scholars of this world is their dislike for the books of Imam Ghazali.
وذلك لأنه من علماء الآخرة.
That is because they're from the scholars. He's from the scholars of the next world.
وقال الإمام الحداد بإحياء علوم الدين تحيا كشف إلهي في أسرع وقت.
And that it is for the prophets that all realities that are unveiled to them, or the majority of them without them even trying or seeking to acquire them or any difficulty from their end, rather that it will come through them through a divine unveiling immediately.
وما دام ذكر الاختلاف في شرف المعلومات وخصتها فيذكر الآن أشرف أنواع العلم.
And so because here he mentioned that there's different